everybody. We're back with another episode of Foods and Dudes. Season 2 is rolling, and we are here and happy to be with you. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to introduce you to our next guest. My man Jerry is here, my friend, my frat brother, a family man like me. We're just going to get it together and make a nice, nice meal for y'all that you'd be happy to make for your family. All right?
My name is Jerry Bright. I'm a married man. I've got two kids. I would say, you can see from my size, I'm a consumer. I'm a provider, and now I'm trying to be a preparer. So it's interesting when I think about my relationship with food. You know, first and foremost, I'm a consumer. You know, I didn't get this big just eating vegetables. I also consider myself a provider. I do have, you know, in addition to my wife, I have a son and a daughter, and they're growing, and they need their sustenance. But you know, now, I am, I guess, in the process of trying to become a preparer. And so this is where, you know, when my wife planted the idea, this it was broached. I figured if you do the first two, you might as well also know how to prepare it as well.
So what we're going to do today, man, this is actually one of the simpler meals, man, for y'all to follow along with and for you to prepare. This is going to be 1, 2, 3, and hopefully you enjoy it. What we're going to prepare is chicken cutlets, lemon chicken cutlets. We're gonna blanch some string beans and dip them in a Grand Marnier or probably a bourbon sauce. Let's switch it up a little bit. And we're also gonna do a variation of a cranberry sauce. All right, so we're gonna do a little cranberry sauce from scratch. So we'll get all that done, and you know, hopefully in record time, and we'll be well on your way to send you home with a wonderful meal for you and your wife.
I am a happily married man of 21 years. I work in finance. I head up business development for a hedge fund. And I also spend a lot of my time with educational causes. I am on the board of trustees for an organization called NYSIS, New York State Association of Independent Schools. I'm also on the board of an independent school called Collegiate. And I'm a former board member involved with the program called Prep for Prep.
Well, I think my wife set me up, so I know she has high expectations, but I know
she should. Let me tell you something. We haven't had a fail yet, you know, so, okay. So don't be the first. You know?
thank you very much. Okay.
Let's just some confidence here, all right? Let's see. These cutlets are nice and thick. These are some big chicken cutlets. What we're going to do is slice them into a manageable size, right? So the first thing we'll do is just make the batter. This is the easiest part of it all, so let's get you started with easy.
Wait, I have to do something?
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay.
A little bit. Right. What I want you to do is crack the 4 eggs, drop them in the bowl, all right?
Where's the bowl?
So this is a bowl.
No! Where's the bowl I put the shells in? Come on! I'm putting the shells.
Bam, look at this.
Where the shells go? I see that.
Listen,
I'm here for instruction, okay?
It's a hard knock life.
So listen, I can do breakfast. My kids will tell you I can do breakfast, and then after that, it's all optional.
Fellas, he's on your side. You know, most of us, did, you know, the bacon, that's all you, right? The eggs, you good to go?
Bacon, eggs, pancakes, fresh toast,
no problem.
I get some challah, some brioche, right. But you know, anything. Now we're doing something a little different.
All right, so what we're gonna do is just add some salt, some pepper. So grab those.
That I can do.
And there you go. Okay. Wow.
Oh, you fancy! Oh, look at that! I thought it was a grinder.
No, what is it with these grinders? Yo, just press the button.
Listen, my wife has a grinder, okay?
Love
it. See? Okay, all right.
Put you back into it.
Okay. I can do that.
Just gotta know what you're working with.
Okay.
So gotcha.
That's about a cup and a half of milk. That was 4 eggs, a teaspoon of crushed black, a teaspoon of salt, and a pinch of lemon pepper and garlic.
Splash.
Gotcha. Very, very careful with chicken. It's been washed already with lemon, a little bit of vinegar and everything, so it's clean. And now we're just gonna go to the next step, all right?
How long do we leave it in here?
We're gonna let that stay there, put it in the fridge and let it keep cool, because we're gonna be frying this later. You want a nice, whenever you're frying, you want the item that you're frying to be cooler than the oil that you're putting it in. That's how you get that nice brown, you know, texture. The inside cooks slowly, and then you do.
That makes a lot of sense.
Next steps, all right. So we're gonna make a sauce, all right? Now, the lemon chicken is gonna be delicious, all right? It's gonna be fried and battered and everything. It's gonna melt in your mouth, but the sauce, man, the sauce, all right? So.
You're about to get me in trouble, man.
Bruh. Listen, you're supposed to go home and do this. It's all about the sauce.
So show me how to make sauce so I can make my wife happy.
So here's what we're gonna do, all right? But we're gonna, that's what takes me.
See, what you trying to do here?
I'm literally just standing here. Y'all heard it? I didn't do it.
I'm just saying.
I didn't do it.
See, make the sauce. I'm
gonna eat that because you're one of the few guys on this show that's actually bigger than me. I'm holding tight to my knife. Okay. So all we're doing is chopping up, man. All right. So these are just smaller peppers. They're all sweet. They look, you know, they're red and whatnot, but they're all sweet peppers. All right. So what we're gonna do is just cut the tops off and then we're just gonna dice them. You've said this a few times, you know, that you are a provider, not a preparer. What do we mean by this?
Well, you know, it's interesting, man. I think about how I grew up and, you know, grew up in the South Bronx, and my mom was always the one who got up in the morning or did the dinner, and my dad was the one who came home. And listen, we're in a different world, and things need to be divided equally.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say if we had to put percentages, I do more of the kind of buying and the consuming versus preparing the materials.
Preparing the materials.
Which is why I know my wife is thrilled. You know, it's interesting. I think about how I grew up. I grew up in the South Bronx.
Right.
And, you know, both my parents from the South, you know, worked hard. My mom worked in social services. My dad did kind of lab work in a hospital, but also grinded, did jobs on the side.
Right.
And, you know, they did all they could for us. And we lived good lives. But, you know, obviously there were times where things maybe could have been better. And I think, you know, we're blessed. We've been able to provide a lot for our kids, but just making sure we keep them grounded.
Right.
And we give them the best opportunities. Mm-hmm. I think, you know, it's all about moving forward that next generation.
So earlier I talked about an organization, Prep for Prep, which is near and dear to my heart. Prep for Prep was founded in 1978 and helps kids in the inner city from lower income neighborhoods, people of color who come from situations where, you know, they're in public schools, and they help prepare them, build up leadership skills so that they can enter elite independent schools. And it was instrumental in my life. I think about growing up, I would watch TV or I would read a book and I would think that's cool, but it wasn't tangible. And what Prep did is it helped get me into this environment where I was going to school with people where all the things I read about and I saw, instead of just reading it, it was real. I actually went to those apartments. I had conversations with my classmates and their parents. And so when I think about our kids, half the battle is just exposure. Exposing and creating opportunities so that they understand what's out there, so that they can realize their runway. You know, when I talk about Prep and I think about my kids, my goal is just to make sure their runway is longer and broader, just so that they can figure out what they want to do.
Well, that's one of those things. Like I can honestly say we share a similar background. Both my parents came from the South. You know, funny stories about how they got here and everything like that. But they both came from the South, and their mantra, as is every parent's hopefully, is to do better for your kids than you have.
That's right.
Like that. And they did. And I think that we're doing better for our kids as well. But it's funny, I'm realizing as they begin to grow that they have this difference of opinion about how life works, right? You know what I mean?
Man, and I think it just speaks to the importance of being intentional. You know, we live in Long Island and we live in the suburbs, and so very different from growing up in the Bronx or in Queens.
Mm-hmm.
And I think about my daughter, the stories, you know, I would be intentional about taking her to Yankee games.
Mm.
I would be intentional about parking by my old neighborhood
right,
just so that,
right.
You know, she saw how I grew up. And it's funny, a couple of months ago, she told me, you know, Dad, I used to hate it when you made me go into the bodega because I was scared.
Mm.
And now I appreciate it because it's, you know, it's just another experience. There's nothing to fear.
No, it's not enough just to make sure that my kids are doing good. You know, I just think about how I raised them, just what I believe. And, you know, we need to create access for other people. You know, we can't be myopic, we can't be self-centered. I mean, I think we're in a world right now where everything is internal focused. We have this tribalism mentality. And I think if we just think a little differently and just, you know, instead of focusing just on our outcomes, but focusing on the outcomes of others, we're going to be in a better place. And that's just what I believe. And particularly when it comes to kids, you know, they're born into this world. They don't ask to be born into this world. So I think it's up to us as adults to just try to create as many opportunities as possible for them so that they can realize and be the best persons or people that they can be.
That's all.
If it cooperates.
Mm-hmm. No, you got to make it cooperate.
All
right. This thing is like...
I can do that. This is not
a... It's like
this,
a 10,000th of your size, bro. Don't let this thing...
Well, I mean, you know. don't judge me.
I will. Never that. What's going to happen is 1, 2, 3. It's grab, bread, place.
Drag it back and forth.
Just drag it back and forth. Until you don't see any glaring spots, you know, any shiny spots.
Now, I need to wash my hands.
You're going to have to wash your hands. We're going to do that off camera. We're not going to let them see that. But so just hold your hands and we'll wash hands off camera and head on over to the stove, all right?
Sounds good.
To the kitchen. All right, so we're going to drop the butter in. There you go.
So again, I'm staying away.
Yep.
Okay, good.
Grab your cut up peppers and the cranberries, the onions. All of that jazz.
All right.
Bring that on over. You can dump it right in.
All right. No signs. Just put it in.
Nope. Just dump it in. There we go.
All right.
How pretty that is. All right. All right. Let's get the onions in there.
I can do some stirring.
Oh, you're going to do all the stirring.
Okay.
Do
it in. All right. So, again, no signs. Just dump this in.
Just dump it in.
Mm-hmm. That's easy. Okay.
That's it. So, it's easy. And now, freestyle a little bit with the pepper.
We can have fun with this now that I know it's a button versus a grinder.
The trick to oil and trick to frying is you don't want to overdo it, okay. All right, with the oil. This isn't a deep fry or anything like that. We want enough oil just to fry one side and then fry the other.
When? Because
Keep going. You can give it a pour. Give it.
I don't want to be heavy handed.
Nah, it's all right. You good. A little more.
About a quarter inch.
That's about a quarter inch right there. You got it.
Mm-hmm. I put this in, right, and so it's going up. It's 185, 210. I feel like this is a game show. 241. 260. So we got some time. I can wait a little while, right?
You can wait a few seconds.
All right. Okay. You know, I appreciate this, man, because I'm feeling more confident as we do this.
There you go.
I still don't want the heat.
And look at this.
I'm not doing that. I'm telling you,
it's still cool.
I'll try that in a second.
Where we at?
I'm waiting for it to stop. Oh, no, we higher than that, man. I think we're...
Where are we?
It's 340,
347. Get your chicken ready.
Okay, it's 345, so we're just about right there. I am bigger than you. If I get burned.
Kind of roll it. Look at that.
Now, all four of these can fit.
All four of those should fit.
Yes. And just set it down.
There you go.
You can go the opposite way to make sure they all fit.
Beautiful. All right, my man. This is about a quarter inch thick. Chicken cooks extremely fast. So about a quarter inch. I would say that this will be done in the next 4 to 5 minutes.
It's going real quick.
So we're going to flip that, grab it. Flip still. And just
got it. That's easy.
And just turn it over. Medium flex. look at the comfort level. You know what I mean? That's it. We just want the grease. And what we're doing is blanching our string beans. All right, so as opposed to boiling.
Blanching. All right.
So your family's from the South, like my family's from the South. What we do? We take some string beans, we get some hog fat, we get all the salt on earth.
Yep.
You throw it in there and you let it boil for like 200 years, right? Okay, and then it comes out, you clog your artery real good, and then you go to the doctor. That sounds about right. Now it's delicious, and I want some just staying it like that, but.
Whole thing. See, that makes it easy.
Mm-hmm. Quarter cup of brown sugar.
Teaspoon.
Red pepper. Quarter teaspoon of kosher salt. So what we're gonna do is liquefy this, all right, with the Hennessy.
So here's my question.
Yes.
I tend to have a heavy hand.
You need a heavy hand because what we have to do is liquefy this.
All right. So.
Go.
Ooh.
Stop. Ooh. All right. Okay. That's about a quarter cup. Right there, so I just need you to mix that up.
Okay. I thought you needed more.
No.
Okay.
The rest is for the glass, I assume.
The rest is with dinner.
For those who partake. Yeah, just stir that up. And if you need to add more, if it doesn't dissolve properly, just add a little bit more.
It's getting this kind of, the color is interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, you have brown sugar, you have a really deep brown cognac, and the salt and the red pepper gives it a good, you know, a good look. And crispy green that looks.
Yeah.
That's a beautiful thing.
Okay.
So we're gonna leave that alone for about 3 minutes. Hey Siri, set an alarm for 2.5 minutes.
I am amazed at how this turned out. I mean, I think about trying to deal with that knife and cutting the meat. I think about dealing with the hot oil. And look at this. And I ate it. It was good. Hey, honey. Now, I clearly know how to do a little something, so I look forward to doing this for you on occasion.
Wow. Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, birthday.
But yes, now I cannot say I don't know how to do it because I have a phenomenal teacher who's showed me how to cook. Yeah. To do this is awesome.
Yo, thank you. I appreciate you being here, man. This was fun.
Absolutely.
Great conversation. I love it. I really appreciate you coming.
All right? This was awesome.
Listen, this is G from Foods and Dudes. Thank you again for watching us. We love you. We thank you for watching. And that is it. Signing off. We'll see you soon.
All right.